Hello everyone, it's Troy here from Tennis Warehouse, filling in for the one and only vlog man. Chris is out today, so I'm filling in for the vlog. I don't have necessarily brand new products for you, but the concept of our vlog today is something that most of you know when we're us testers here. I like to customize rackets, add weight to them, kind of dial them in, get them right in our wheelhouse as far as specs go. So I picked out some frames here that I really hold dear, really like, a lot of control and feel type rackets, but I think they would benefit from a little bit of customization as far as like the specs that I like. Not to say that they don't play great already in stock form, it's just that the way I like my specs, and maybe some of you out there could find that a little bit of fine tuning with the customization is a good way to go with these. So I'll start off with some of the new offerings, stuff that we just recently have been play testing. We have the Wilson Ultra Pro rackets here, beautiful frames, straight out of Wilson Pro Labs. So it's got that, you know, beautiful thin beam here. Really, we're all really loving the paint job, kind of the color shift that they're going with, and it kind of has that blue to purple look. So great frames here. But one thing that I noticed, and maybe some of you others out there that have tried these Ultra Pro, Ultra Tours, really low swing weight, so very, very maneuverable, but not a ton of put away power, not a lot of plow through like we like to say. So these rackets could definitely benefit from some added head weight. We have our Tennis Warehouse tungsten tape that we typically use, and I definitely would be adding some, probably up in the 12 o'clock, also maybe 3 and 9 o'clock regions on these frames, just to increase that swing weight, give you a little bit more stability against hard hitters, and just some added plow through power. So good ones to customize there. Next one up, a beautiful frame here, the new Yonex Percept. This is the 97310. There's also the H version of 330 and the 320 97D with the 1820 pattern. But I like to customize this one because those heavier ones, they're great in stock form, but they don't give me the room to really customize or put a leather grip on the racket like I tend to prefer. So this one here, I kind of mimic the look of the Stan the Man racket. It's got the leather grip, kind of the shorter wrap job, and the more overlap like Stan does for his one-handed backhand. But just a beautiful frame, added some weight up at the tip here, a little bit at 3 and 9, and then the leather grip. This one's coming in swing weight right around a little over 330, about 332, and about 12.2 ounces strung. So nice spec there, and just loving playing with this, love looking at this racket. That's the new Percept. Another Yonex frame, the V-Core 95. We tested this a while ago. A lot of you players out there that have tried it really know how good of a frame this one is. The new V-Core line's a little bit softer, a little more comfortable on the arm, but also a very maneuverable frame, low swing weight. So I added some Tennis Warehouse tungsten tape up in the hoop, also some weight in the handle with our tungsten putty. And this one actually has a spec on it right now. This one's pretty high, 337 swing weight, also about 12.2, so really nice spec going on. Definitely beef this V-Core 95 up, fun to play with. Next two rackets, Technifiber rackets, really liking these frames. Two different types of customization going on. So first one, the T-Fight 305. Most people out there know it as kind of like the Medvedev frame. This one already has a ton of head weight, kind of like a, I don't know, a Babolat Pure Strike or a Wilson Blade. Pretty high swing weight in stock form, so I wouldn't really be adding any head weight to this one, but this one I would like to tail weight. The only problem is with Technifiber rackets is there isn't a trap door to insert weight inside the handle. So on this one, I added a shrink sleeve, which builds up the grip from this one's a quarter to a 3/8, which I like, and then put a leather grip on top of that. So that added quite a bit of weight to the bottom half. Another thing you can do is remove the grip. You can put lead tape on the pallet, and then from there I like to put like a clear kind of office tape on top just to seal it, protect it, and then re-grip it. So those are a couple ways you can customize Technifiber rackets on the bottom half since they don't have that trap door. Next one is the TF4315. This one's kind of the opposite as far as the swing weight and the balance. Really low swing weight in stock form, kind of like some of these other ones. So I added a lot of Tennis Warehouse tungsten tape on this one to bring up the swing weight. And this one, the swing weight's about 333 right now. So really love both of these frames. This one's a little softer. This one's a little firmer, more pop, a little more control and feel with the TF40. Next few, to wrap things up, we got the Dunlop CX200 Tour. This is the 18x20, also comes in a 16x19, so kind of like the Ultra Pros, two patterns here, but just a really nice player frame, thin beam, lots of control and feel. And these, like the Ultra Pros, have pretty low swing weights in stock form, so I definitely would be adding some tungsten tape up in the hoop, probably bring the swing weight up closer to the 330 range, kind of what I like. Already comes with a leather grip, so that's great. And these ones, you can add weight inside the handle there. You can remove the trap door if you want to add even more handle weight. So Dunlop CX200 Tours, great frames. And then the last couple here, we have a Prince racket from our Phantom series. This is the 100G. Beautiful frame. I love the retro vibe here with the crossbar, kind of like the old school classic graphites. Super soft. Really open string pattern, very spin friendly, 100 square inch head size. I'd love this racket in stock form. I just felt like it was missing that plow through, that put away power. So definitely would doctor this one up. This one has some lead tape up in the hoop right there. Also put a leather grip on this one, and you could even add more weight inside the trap door if you want. This one has a swing weight right at 331, so just swings really, really nice. Beautiful frame there from Prince. And then last but not least, it wouldn't be a pick of some of my favorite rackets without an extended in there. This is one of the newer Solinkos, the 1820 extended version. And customization on this, I do have a little bit of weight up in the hoop, but Solinko makes this one really easy to customize because they have weighted trap doors for the butt cap. So you can actually purchase those. You don't have to put, you know, tungsten or anything. You can just add the heavier butt caps. There's like a 5 gram increase and a 10 gram increase. We have videos on that, but really loving the extended Solinko rackets that you can easily customize. So that's all I got for this week's vlog. Thanks for tuning in. We'll see you next week.